I told Andrew I was going to give you people a choice this morning of whether you wanted to have an active practice or a more meditative, relaxing practice. And Andrew, I'm going to get you.
I'll go for the active.
You'll go for the active practice?
Mm-hmm. I go for the meditative.
Meditative. Now I'll squeal on Andrew because I asked him before we left and he said I would like to do the meditative practice because we did quite a bit of canoeing yesterday, and so I said, okay, I'll start with you and you can see if that influences the path. So he's playing the devil's advocate. So I think we'll start with the meditative. We'll have a meditative practice. So what I'm going to do is try to frame the practice with meditation at the beginning and another integrative meditation at the end. So the first thing you can do is roll onto your back and take a constructive resting pose, which is your feet are flat on the ground, your knees are bent, your arms can be out to the side or just lightly resting on your chest, whichever is most comfortable. And just gently roll your head from side to side and then let your head come to settle. So as we settle into a time of ease and very gentle yoga practice this morning, it will be helpful to begin by relaxing the body and letting go of any places where you may be holding tension this morning. So just take your awareness and begin at the tips of your toes, breathe in deeply, and just let any tension sink from your toes down into the breathing deeply to support this relaxation practice. Let your awareness move up from your toes to your ankles, to your shins, up your legs, to knees, up your upper legs, to your hips, your torso. Relax around the heart. Feel the back of the heart opening and spreading. Relaxation moving through your body. Relax your neck, your head. Feel relaxation moving along your shoulders, down your arms, to your fingertips. Take a deep breath to support this relaxation. In fact, take a couple of deep, easy breaths. To feel the tension moving out of your body, being grounded into the mat. Now let go of the practice of breathing deeply and just let your breath return to its normal pace. Feel the sweetness of the cool air moving in the nostrils, down into the lungs. Feel the gentle breath exiting the body. And remind yourself for the next 50 minutes or so that this is a time to be present with yourself. There's very little agenda here this morning. There's no one that you have to be. There's nowhere to go. And really, there's nothing to do except relax. Be present with yourself. We can think of this time as a time of giving a gift to ourselves. And actually, the more we begin to relax as we practice, the more we may become aware of tension that we are holding without really knowing. And we also can realize just how much the mind and the body appreciates this opportunity of being witnessed, of being deeply seen and deeply cared for. Let yourself connect to an intention to be present with yourself for this next period. And if it's possible, bring a sense of well-wishing to yourself. Just see if you can think of one or two kind thoughts for for yourself. May I be happy. May I be safe. May I be at ease in my body and mind. This isn't a demand, it's just a simple expression of the natural wish that we all have to be happy. This quality of well-wishing and kindness can be an attitude that infuses our yoga practice this morning. And in fact, we can bring our awareness and mindfulness to this sense of well-being for the rest of today. Just connecting to the process of relaxation, just relaxing the body, is a kind thing that you can do for yourself. Connecting with the experience of breathing in and breathing out in a very gentle way. So can you offer yourself an experience of being gentle with your breath? Gentle with your body, which works so hard. This breath that keeps us alive. Bring a friendly attention, a friendly awareness to the present moment. And for a few moments, just explore the breath and the body as a way of making friends. Breathing in, knowing that you're breathing in, breathing out, aware that you're breathing out. And if any other experiences, any sounds, any other body sensations compete with the breath for your attention, see if there can also be a friendly attitude or a kindness toward those other experiences as well. Bring an inclusive attitude to the sounds that arise and see if you can just be present on that with your breath, with other body sensations, with any emotions that might arise. See if you can extend this sense of inclusion into creating friendly relationship with everything that occurs and doesn't include or exclude any experience. From time to time, there might be a tendency for your mind to wander away from the mat. So when you become aware that your mind has been wandering, just take a moment to pause and notice how you are right there and right then. The mind, having been wandering, will change the landscape of your experience. So just take a moment to become friends with that as well. To welcome whatever arises. Because whatever happens in the next little while, can be known, it can be included, and as it is included, you can also gently reconnect with your breath, not needing to push any experience away, but opening to include anything that arises in with the breath. In this way, we can stay in contact with our experience, we can stay connected, the experience of breathing, and yet, although we're focusing on our breath, we're not pushing any other experience away. We bring a friendly and a kind attention to whatever happens in the present moment. This
this receptive space that we're creating can open and hold anything, including uneasiness, impatience, maybe a bit of irritation. We don't have to push anything away. We can open to accept whatever happens. Happiness, peacefulness, ease, confusion, they can all be included. Allowing the sense of appreciation and kindness to move in the body, through the body, and around the body. Connecting you to the spacious ease of relaxation and well-being. So just rest for a moment in whatever field of kindness and love arises. Bring your attention to the center of your heart. Once again, bring your attention to your breath. Allow your breath to deepen. On the next inhale, lift your knees toward your chest. Wrap your arms around your knees. And just hold yourself for a moment in a space of kindness and acceptance. And then when you're ready, roll over to one side and gently push yourself up to sitting. So we're going to just take the back of the mat and roll the mat up. Two-thirds of the way, just to create a little bit of rise for the hips. So Jim, you might want to adjust, have it smaller, or like sit on it and see how it feels. So we just want to raise the hips just slightly, but I know that it's not comfortable for you sitting on the block, so it's,
yeah.
How does this work?
Sure.
We're going to start off by easing some tension in the neck and shoulders, if you feel like community muscles. So we're going to begin by taking the right hand and just sliding the right hand out to the side. Left hand out to the side as well. Tip the right ear toward the shoulder. Press the right palm into the and inhale the left arm up with the head. Yep. Bringing the right ear closer to the shoulder. Exhale and bring this arm down to about 30 degrees. See how this deepens the stretch, the side of the neck. And then just begin to play with your outstretched arm. Turn the palm up, down. You can move it slightly forward, slightly back. Just see how this feels in the neck. If you can feel it changing, deepening the stretch. And then with your head, you can tip, play with tipping your chin toward the chest. Chin slightly up to the ceiling, and then begin putting both motions together, turning and moving the outstretched arm, or if taking your chin through a range of motion, see if you can feel the stretch changing places. And bring your left hand up to shoulder height, palm facing down. Stretch out through your fingertips to the opposite wall, and at the same time, take the right hand and gently push down, and then bring both palms down. So what we're doing is playing with little movements so we can see if we can feel the different muscles inside of the neck. So we'll slide the left palm out. Tip left ear toward the shoulder. Raise the other arm up. Take a nice deep inhale. And then gently bring the arm down to about 30 degrees to wherever you'd feel most intensity and stretch. And then begin to play with turning the palm to the ceiling, down. You can move the arms slightly forward, slightly back. You can feel how this is not only pulling on the neck, but it's also working the muscles of the shoulder. And then you can begin to experiment with tipping the chin toward the chest, maybe a little bit. Ear a little bit closer to the shoulder, chin up. And then you can combine moving the head and playing with the arm as well. And then take the arm that's in the air to shoulder height. Press out actively through the fingertips so that you can feel the line of energy moving down your arm, out through the fingers. Lift the other hand, place it on the head, and very gently bring it back up. Relax. Place both palms on your knees. Roll your shoulders forward. Scrunch your shoulders up, really scrunch them right up to your ears, and then just let them gently fall. And once more, this time we'll scrunch them up to the ears. Take a deep inhale, and then on the exhale, we'll let the shoulders fall quite rapidly. So inhale, and then once more, shoulders up, exhale. Once more up. And this time we'll bring the shoulders down and toward the back very slowly. Going to take the fingers and interlace the palms together. And just gently pull palms a little bit apart. We're going to do an isometric exercise for the neck and shoulders. We're going to begin by taking the palms to the back of the head, placing the palms just above the occipital bone. We're going to press the head into the hands, and the hands are going to resist. So press the head back, hold for one deep breath. And do that twice more, allowing your own breath to control the length of hold. And try to keep your chin parallel to the floor, and also try not to clench your jaw. So we're just moving the neck and release. Let go of your fingers, bring your palms front, and just lightly touch each one of your fingertips, and then back again. Your hands a little shake. Interlace palms, place them back behind your head. This time the head is going to stay stationary and relaxed. I'm going to press the palms into the head. So press with your arms. Twice more. holding as your own breath asks, and let go of your head and lift your fingers up to the ceiling and just press up through the heels of your palms. Again, this time we're going to put the palms on the forehead, and we'll begin by exercising the neck. So we're going to press into the hands with the forehead, then in place, and twice more, holding as long as you wish. Thumbs down like this, and then just gently press your palms forward. You can probably feel the muscles that she needs to work on. Interlace the palms again. Here. And this time we're going to do the opposite. We're going to keep the head and neck still. Press into the head with the palms. And twice more. Palms just slightly pull, so we're just creating a little bit of tension. We'll do a little bit of wrist flossing. So using the right wrist, we'll push forward with the wrist, and just let the left wrist bend in. So the right wrist is active and the left wrist is passive. And then we'll go back to center, and this time press forward with the left. Motion that we recommend to people who suffer from carpal tunnel. So you can probably feel it pulling all up on that top. We'll take our hands and interlace our fingers behind the back. And then bend the elbows and take both arms to the side. And then just very gently tip ear to the shoulder. See if you can keep your face relaxed. Take a deep breath. Come back up. Release your hands. Shake. Take your palms in front of your heart and press the heels of your palms together, and then join your palms, pressing as tightly as you can. Pressing both, and then spread your fingers, relax your shoulders, and your glutes to the window. And then bring your elbows and fingers together. And once more, we'll interlace fingers behind the back. And then we'll take both arms to the opposite side.
grab some energy and pull it down the front of your body.
Take one palm out in front and then just very gently, very, very gently flex fingers down and let go. Feel that stretch up in the upper arm, up into your shoulder. And just give your hands a little shake. This is my favorite arm stretch. So we're going to take our palms like this, put the thumbs toward the center. Wrap the other fingers around. Bend your wrists in. Take your arms out like Popeye. And then keeping your wrist bent, straighten your arms. Very gentle. You can feel this incredible stretch. And then open the palms. Just put your hands down. And then we'll come up to standing. So we're going to do a standing twist that comes to us courtesy of Sri Sri Ravi Shankar. So this will be familiar to you, Andrew. So we're going to inhale, arms up, palms facing each other. And then just very gently exhale. Right, keeping your head, your chin over your heart. And then when you've turned as far to the right as you can, just very gently take your head to look over your shoulder. Inhale, feel your feet pressing deeply into the mat. Then bring your head back to your chin over your heart. A little shake. Feel your feet about hip width apart, rooting into the mat. There's energy moving down through your legs. There's also energy moving up the spine. Inhale, hands parallel. And then beginning with your navel, imagine your navel beginning to twist. Chin over the heart. And then when you've twisted as far as you can, just let your head gently. Inhale, both arms up to the side. Turn your palms to face over. And then begin to twist in the direction of your front leg. Extra bell balance pose unless we manage to lose our balance during it. So this time we're going to cross the left leg over the right. We're going to bring the arms up and just place them on the shoulders like this. And close your eyes and then begin to twist in the direction of the front leg. See if closing your eyes changes your sensation.
want to give yourself a little bit more of a challenge, you can try this with your eyes straight. Close your eyes. Twist. And then back to center. And actually, the more you're kind of rocking from side to side, the more you're strengthening the neural pathways in your brain, and the better your balance is. Okay. So now we'll just come back down to the mat. You can come through Utkatasana. Knees. Feel the weight and then just come down. Or you can just come down to sitting. So we're going to lie on our backs and do a very gentle upper body and shoulder relaxing. So what's going to happen is when we're lying on our back, we're going to roll onto our side, have both of our palms like this, and then one palm's going to come up, and as we get to here, the other palm's going to come, and our whole body is going to just flow from side to side. So, back. And then roll over onto your left side, and have your palm, your arms coming straight out from your shoulders with one palm on top of the other. I think you could bend your knees in slightly towards your chest. And just take your top palm and slide it out along the bottom palm onto the floor. And back. And just do this two or three times. As kind of beginning to suggest to your shoulders and upper and middle back that it would very much like to relax. Okay, bring both palms together. And then very gently take your upper arm and bring it up over your head and allow your whole body to start to move. Bring your lower arm. Roll right over to the other side. And then let your palms slide across top. And bring your other arm around you to follow. Yeah. And then just let your palms slide out once or twice. And then take your upper arm over the head. Let the lower arm follow. Let your hips. And just roll gently from. More to each side, and then just come to resting on your back with your knees bent and your arms out in a T-shape. Bend your knees and bring your knees up to the ceiling and your feet flat on the mat. And roll over to your right side. bend your elbows so that your right upper arm is on the mat and your head is resting in the palm of your right hand. So if you want to see, so you're up on your upper arm. Okay, and we've done this before, it's called the clamshell. We're going to inhale and pressing in, you can use your left hand, press into the mat, and then just gently open and close the knee, the top knee. And you have your bottom leg off the mat, both legs are up in the air. Sorry, I should have had you roll to the other side first to see.
I'll get a mirror and stuff.
And then when you think that this is enough work for your side body, just bring your knees down to the mat, roll over onto your back, your knees pointing up to the ceiling, and then just let your knees rock a little from side to side. And then roll onto your left side, up your head, lift the lower knees, and then just open and close the knees. And then when you've had as much of this as you wish to do this morning, just come back down to the mat. And roll onto your back. And hug your knees into your chest. And just release any tension. Just kind of gently rock from side to side. Massaging along the sacrum. And then bring your legs to the mat. And straighten your legs. And just press. Feel yourself sinking down to the mat. Bend your knees, bring your feet to the mat, very close to your bottom. And then inhale and bring your knees up toward your chest. Going to do another little isometric exercise that's going to help realign your pelvis. So place your palms of your hands just in front of your knees and flat this, and we're going to push the knees away with the palms, and the knees are going to resist. Press and release. And twice more, the length of the hold determined by your own breath and your own body. And release. And then press. And release. Slide your palms to the front of your knees. And this time you're going to pull your knees toward you with your palms as your knees resist and push away into the palms. Press. You can feel how this uses a different set of muscles in both the arms and legs. Press. And release. Once more, press. And release. And then just let your feet come down to the mat. And now a little movement for releasing any kind of pain or tension, tightness in the hips and the pelvis that comes from awareness through movement, through Feldenkrais. So we're going to take the right knee, bring it up, inhale it up, and cross it over the left knee. You can take your arms out to the sides, probably about a 30-degree angle, or if they feel more comfortable on the straight, that's fine too.
And then just very gently begin to tip both of your knees toward the right. Tipping in the direction of the knee that's on top. And just back up to center. We're going to do this 10 times, looking at your own pace. Just gentle little micro movements. Keeping the foot that's on the floor, the toes pointed toward the wall. And just gently rocking back and forth. If your pelvis wants to join in, that's quite fine. And feel this lovely sense of connection. Come back to center with the knees pointing toward the ceiling. Take your left arm and keep your knees crossed. Slide your left arm up so that it's in a 12 o'clock position with the palm facing the ceiling. It's on the floor again. Okay, so slide it up. Yeah, like you're doing a clock. And then just for a couple of movements, stretch your fingers toward the back ceiling, the back wall. Feel the movement in the shoulder and then let the shoulder and arm come back to resting. And then push the fingers toward the wall and back to resting. And once more, fingers toward the wall and back to resting. This time we're going to gently tip the legs over toward the right as we push the fingers back toward the wall. So stretch the fingers as you're rolling toward the right. And you should feel a really lovely stretch in the back. And then bring the arm back to the shoulder. And then just go through this gentle stretching movement. Three or four. Arm down toward your body, uncross your legs, and just take a moment to see if one side of your hips feels different than the other. You might be making a little bit more contact with the mat. And then cross the opposite leg to the other knee. And begin to just gently let the legs fall toward the left. Back to center. And just moving slowly with awareness. Let your knees fall to the side and come back to pointing toward the ceiling. About eight. Move as slowly or as quickly as you like, as long as you keep your awareness focused on the movement that's happening in the hip, down along the top of the leg. Stretching the fingers and release. Let's take a deep breath, relax for a moment, and then begin to let your legs fall toward the left as your right arm stretches toward the back wall. And move gently and slowly through this stretching and retracting. Four more. As quickly or as slowly as feels pleasant, and see if you can keep your jaw relaxed, relax your neck, relax around your eyes. And then when you're done, bring your arm back down to the side, uncross your legs, and just rest for a moment. Now you should feel both sides of your pelvis nice and firmly contacted with the mat. Slide your legs out straight. And now bend the left leg so that your left knee is pointing toward the ceiling. Take your straightened right leg and turn your toes out toward the opposite wall so that you're putting your leg in an external rotation. Bend the knee and pull your knee up toward your chest, up sliding on the floor so your knee is. Rotate your toes to the opposite direction there. Okay, and then just bend your knee up. And what we're going to do is slide the bottom foot under your bent knee like this. Once your knee gets under, take your left hand and reach down and just take hold of your toes. Reach your toes. Perfect. If not, okay, hold for a second, and then release your toes, slide your leg back out, and bring the right leg straight down to the mat again. Turn the toes out toward the outer wall, bend the knee and slide the knee up, or slip it underneath. Grab hold of your toes and just gently pull your foot toward your body. And then release. Let both of your legs go straight to the mat. This time bend the right leg so the right knee is standing. Turn the left toes out toward the outside wall and slide, bend your knee and slide your left knee along and bring your foot underneath. Gently reach down with your right arm, take hold of your toes, and then release. Slide your knee, foot back out, bring your leg down straight. And repeat that movement once more. So turn your toes out toward wall, bend the knees, slide up, slide it through. Take hold of your toes and just gently pull the foot toward your body. And then release. Take both legs out straight. One more very subtle little movement. I'm going to bend the left foot so the knee is, bend the left knee so the knee is facing toward the ceiling. This time as you turn the right toes outward and begin to bend the knee, roll slightly onto your right hip so that your left hip is off the mat. Slide the foot underneath the standing knee. Reach down and this time pull your foot underneath your pelvis. And just hold for a moment. And then release. bend the opposite knee. Turn the toes of the left foot out. Bring the knee up toward the body. Roll onto the left hip. Slide the leg through. Take your foot underneath. Bring both knees to standing. And then just gently let your knees, windshield wiper from side to side. And then bring your knees up to facing. On the next inhale, bring your knees towards your chest. And once again, place the palms of your hands on the front of your knees, pushing your palms into your knees and your knees into your palms. Hold. One more time, pressing with the palms. Knees and knees. Bring your feet down to the mat and just give your knees a little bit of a shake. And then bring your knees back up to your chest. Slide your palms to the outside of the knees. And this time, pulling with the arms and pushing. Side to side, and then finally come to rest. Bring your awareness to the tips of your toes. Begin to slowly move your attention up your body from the tips of your toes, up your legs, up your torso, chest, across the shoulders and down to the fingertips. Just take a moment to rest in the space of ease and peace that you've created. Feel the energy moving through the body and beginning to settle and integrate the movements that you've done into your being. And if you can remember, recall the kind intention that you had for yourself before you began to practice this mantra. Feel the sweetness of the breath as it enters in through the nostrils, cool air moving in through the nose, down toward the heart center. Feel how the breath as it exits the body moves from the heart center up and out through the nose. Feel how this air has been warmed by the energy of your body. Slide your legs together so that you're pressing your heels and your big toes together. Bring a little bit of movement to your toes. Bring a little bit of movement to your fingertips. Inhale and bring your knees to your chest. And with your arms, take this great field of ease and kindness that you've created and wrap it around yourself. And then very gently rock from side to side, eventually rolling onto your right side, creating a little pillow for your head with your lower arm. Just take a moment to pause. I hope that you're feeling a sense of ease that you can take from this practice into the rest of your day. So just gently, when you're ready, using your arms, push yourself up to sitting. Slightly close your eyes, bring your palms together. We'll just end the practice with listening to the sound of the bell. Tip your chin toward your heart.